Hey there, and welcome back to yet another one of my YouTube videos. I have an OG BMW M2 right here, and an M2 CS right here, so I thought, why not compare the differences that no one ever talks about? Let's get this video started with some differences that you'd only ever notice if you drove both cars on the track. When I first got my OG M2, I tracked it almost right away, and I was blown away at how fun it was. It handles so well. Coming out of a corner, going on a straightaway, this thing moves. It's a lot of fun. And if I didn't say it already, you get great turn-in as well. You'd honestly think that this is a supercar. That is until you drive this, because the turn-in on this is insane. I have Cup 2 tires on my car right now, which are amazing track tires. They were fully warmed up, and I took my OG M2 out. Then right after, I took this out on Pilot Super Sports, which are still good tires, but definitely not a track tire. And this turned in so well. I was shocked. The grip is amazing. You can go around corners a lot faster and you feel a lot more confident. This thing is a monster on the track. I'm not saying that the OG M2 is bad on the track by any means. It's a great track car. But the thing is, once you drive the CS, you realize that there's a level above the M2, which is honestly a high level already. But confidence isn't the only thing you want to have on the track. You want to have a lot of fun. And if you want to have a lot of fun, get one of these cars. The thing is though, this car is Sport Plus mode, which has traction turned off halfway, but it's tuned a little bit differently. When you get in this car, it has MDM mode, and that's tuned perfectly, because in this car, you'll get a little bit of slip. You can't do drifts in Sport Plus for the most part when your tires are warmed up. It's more so of a safer road going traction mode where you're not going to lose the car, but you can still have a little bit of fun. In this car, you put MDM mode on and just look at this for yourself. That's what I wanted to do. Let's go. You can do full drifts out of corners. It is amazing. MDM mode is so fun in this car. That's about it for stuff you'll only notice on the track. There's a bunch of other things you'll notice, but these are the things that you need to be on track to notice. Anyways, let's move on to the stuff that you'll notice on the road driving it day to day. Okay, so since we made this car look like a horrible car for the whole start of the video, let's turn it around. This has almost instant torque. If you look at this dyno graph, the torque starts early, and this car is literally like a rocket ship. You put your foot down, this car goes. When you're in a corner and you put your foot down, it's predictable as well. You don't have a spike of boost, so you have a lot of confidence in corners, and you have a lot of fun just smashing the pedal down and the car going. Then we get to the M2 CS. So, I guess this is something that you would notice on track, but it's also definitely something you could notice on the road. There is quite a bit of space in the rev range until you hit boost. So what this means is, let's say you're on a corner and you floor it, you might oversteer quite a bit. It's also a little bit, not annoying, but it's noticeable when you're in lower rev ranges and you want to just floor it and go. There is a slight delay. This car pops a lot. I mean, a lot. Right now it's tuned, so of course it pops even more, but even when I picked it up from the dealer completely stock, it popped a lot and it sounded amazing with those pops. To be fair, it does have the M Performance exhaust on here, which brings me to the M2 CS not being able to option the M Performance exhaust. You only get the stock CS exhaust and that's it. I'm guessing you probably could get the dealer to install it for you, but it's not a factory option. The second thing about this is that even with an upgraded Dynan exhaust, it still doesn't pop a whole lot. And from the dealer, it barely popped at all. You'd have to get perfect conditions without any road noise to hear even the smallest baby pops. I'm guessing that's because it's more of a track car and the target market for it probably doesn't want a whole lot of pops. It's easily fixable with coding. And yet another thing about the OG M2 being slightly better is that you get a lot more intake noise. Stock to stock, it's quite similar, but both Daryl and I have upgraded intakes and you get a lot more intake noise out of mine. Here's Here's the last thing about the sound, I promise. Since there are different engines in these two, they do sound different from the back, but something that's actually really interesting is that they sound different from the cabin as well. And you're probably thinking to yourself, obviously, but what I'm talking about is the engine noise, not the exhaust note in the cabin. This sounds very buttery and smooth in the cabin. It's a very nice engine noise, and it's kind of hard to explain, so I'll just put a clip in right here. And this, on the other hand, sounds a little bit more, not as smooth, I guess you could say. It's hard to explain, so I'll just put a clip in. Since we finished off the road segment, here are some cool things in general about the cars. Both the OG M2 and the M2 CS are available in blues, but for the OG M2, there's Long Beach Blue, metallic, and for the CS, there's Mezzano Blue. Both blues are found on other cars, so they're not specific to the M2, but the thing is, you can't get Long Beach Blue on the CS, and you can't get Mezzano Blue on the OG. Maybe you could with BMW individual, but from factory, normally, you can't. The OG M2 normally comes with 4-piston front brakes and 2-piston rear brakes, but I upgraded them to the 6-piston front brakes and 4-piston rear brakes. With the smaller brakes though, BMW didn't feel the need to put brake ducts in here, so there's no brake cooling for the OG M2's brakes, but on the M2 CS they come standard with either the carbon ceramics with 6-pistons or the steels with 6-pistons, which are the same ones on my car, and these do have brake ducts, right there and right there. The cool thing about these brake ducts is that there's actually a flap in the wheel well with a screw, and you can either open them or close them, whether you're going on the road or the track. The last few things I want to cover are aesthetic changes. So for example, the carbon lip, and actually the first one that I want to show you is not an aesthetic change, but let's get into that right now. The OG M2 has this beautiful N55 engine, and the M2 CS has this beautiful S55 engine with these awesome Evensherry carbon intakes that I got Dale for Christmas. From factory, the OG M2 doesn't have any of this carbon. It doesn't have a carbon lip, these carbon fangs, or these carbon grills. What it has is the bumper, and that's it. The CS, on the other hand, gets this carbon lip from factory, carbon mirrors, and since we're on the mirrors, the M2 CS gets M mirrors, whereas these get the regular BMW F-series mirrors. I just put different caps on. The carbon diffuser and the carbon spoiler. Whereas the OG M2 comes with a plastic diffuser with no fins and a small, I believe it's aluminum spoiler. The M2 CS has an updated front bumper and front grille, kind of like the M5 where it connects together. And this is a very aggressive shape, but it's not really the iconic BMW grille where it's separated and it's two. Another difference is that these fangs are slightly different. If we go over to the M2, the differences here are, they're covered here, but the fangs are a little bit bigger. And also, the grills are spaced out. And actually, I forgot one thing on the CS. We have the brake ducts, which I covered earlier. The BMW M2 CS comes standard with this really cool, fun to use and fun to look at Alcantara steering wheel, whereas the OG M2 comes standard with a leather steering wheel. It's a very nice steering wheel. If you look over here, both cars have carbon fiber hoods, except the OG M2 doesn't come standard with it, whereas Daryl's does. It's very light and it has this cool design, which is different from the regular carbon GTS hood that the M3 and M4 CS have. If you come over here, it also has a carbon fiber roof, which is the only M2 to be offered with it. The other M2s either come with an aluminum roof or an aluminum roof with a sunroof. I've wrapped mine in carbon though, so technically I have a carbon fiber roof and a sunroof, if anybody asks. The last two differences between the M2 CS and the OG M2 is that the M2 CS has a carbon fiber center console, whereas all the M2s come with a plastic one. And the last thing is that the M2 CS has adaptive suspension, but I'm gonna have a really hard time showing you that. So that's pretty much everything for the differences between the OG M2 and the M2 CS. If I miss one, please let me know in the comments, because I'm sure there's a lot of owners who went from an OG M2 to an M2 CS. Anyways, thank you so much for watching today's YouTube video. I will be posting once a week from now on. Every single week. The reason I wasn't posting as much before is because the cars were parked, which is really obvious when you look at Daryl's car. It's a little dirty. Anyways, like I said before, I really appreciate you tuning into this video. I will have another video at Thursday at 9 a.m. next week, and it's gonna be a really cool video. just like every other video that's coming. I want to do some road trips and some other cool things, so if you have any ideas or anything you want to see, let me know in the comments and I'll most likely make them. Anyways, with that being said, I really hope you have a fantastic rest of your week.